The Philippine Trade Department cracks down on the sale of uncertified appliances. In its latest operation in Plaridel, Bulacan, the DTI's Task Force Calasag seized a record 44 million pesos worth of household appliances that have not passed technical regulations. In a span of just 3 months since the task force was activated, they've already seized nearly 118 million pesos worth of goods. The DTI now reminds consumers to check the quality of the products they're buying. The Philippines is a top destination for luxury real estate. That's according to high-end brokerage firm Nest Seekers International. It says the growing ultra-rich segment in the country is fueling the accelerated appreciation of local property prices.
Our penthouse, out of 7 penthouses, 6 of them are already sold, and the price point for that would be $15 million to about $20 million. Most of it are foreign buyers, which signifies that Philippines is becoming a investment destination. And also, we are also looking at the robust economy and Philippines being named as the fastest appreciating luxury real estate market since last year, with an annual price gains of 26.3%, overtaking Dubai, Shanghai, and other more established markets.
Iran's supreme leader vows retaliation for the assassination of Hamas's leader. A pre-dawn strike by Israel in Tehran killed Hamas political chief Ismail Haniyeh. Iran now warns Israel of harsh punishment and said it considers revenge as their duty. The assassination is feared to reverberate across the region and threatens to prompt Hamas to pull out of talks for a ceasefire in Gaza. Speaking to reporters in Manila, U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin said Washington remains committed to de-escalating tensions in the Middle East.
I don't think war is inevitable. I maintain that. I think there's always room and opportunities for diplomacy, and I'd like to see parties pursue those opportunities. And certainly what we've seen along the border, the northern border with Israel, over time, that's, you know, that's been a concern of ours. We're going to do everything we can to make sure that we keep things from turning into a broader conflict throughout the region.
The largest wildfire in the United States, now bigger than the city of Los Angeles, the so-called Park Fire in a wilderness area north of Sacramento, has swelled to over 950 square kilometers. More than 5,500 firefighters across California and other states are working round the clock to battle the blaze. The Park Fires forced the evacuation of more than 4,000 people and destroyed or damaged more than 190 structures. The man accused of starting the fire has been formally charged with arson and is awaiting additional charges. The oil spill off the waters of Bataan reaches the province of Cavite. Cavite Governor John Victorino Mulia confirmed the oil spill has already spread in the municipalities of Bacoor, Kawit, Noveleta, Rosario, Tansa, Naik, Maragondon, and Ternate. All 8 areas have been placed under a state of calamity. The province also declaring a shellfish ban in light of the incident. The governor also shared a video of crabs covered in oil spill. Some fisher folk from Cavite say they are struggling to fish due to the overwhelming smell of gasoline in the water. The recent southwest monsoon-enhanced typhoon Karina also impacted their boats and houses.
Hindi ho kami nakapalaon ngayon kasi ang isda ngayon dito may amoy.
May amoy gasolina?
Apo.
Ay ba't gano'n? Meron pa ba kayo nakikita diyang mga nakalutang na mga oil spill, sa galing sa oil spill?
Eh, mayroon pa ho, pa butil-butil na lang.